several years ago now, I participated with a group on a mission project with youth. It was part of an organization called Teens Opposing Poverty, or TOPS for short. And what we did was walk down the street that was parallel to the mall where the Capitol and the Washington Monument are in downtown DC. And we had made sandwiches that we passed out to people along the way. One of the people that was helping us was an employee of this organization named William. And at one point in his life, William had been unhoused. And as we walked down that street, he would point out people to us that we had not seen. We had walked past them, not seeing them at all. It was interesting to me how those people, because William knew where to look, he could point them out to us, but they had been invisible to us. When did we see you? I welcome you to this online expression of worship from Pell City First United Methodist Church. My name is Rachel Gonya. I'm the senior pastor here, and I'm glad that you've decided to join us in this way. Today, our scripture reading is from Matthew 25, a passage that probably is familiar to many of you. Jesus is speaking, and he says this: "When the Son of Man comes in glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, 'Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him, 'Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you?' And the king will answer them, 'Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me.' Then he will say to those at his left hand, 'You that are accursed, depart from me into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. I was naked, and you did not give me clothing, sick and in prison, and you did not visit me.' Then they will answer, 'Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not take care of you?' Then he will answer them, 'Truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me.' And then they will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life." This is the word of God for the people of God. When did we see you? When did we not see you? That's the question that both those who are judged to be sheep or goats ask Jesus. Both ask the same question because they didn't recognize Christ. When did we not see you, Lord? When did we see you? When you were hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison? Neither of them had seen Jesus in those who were in need, in the hungry, the thirsty, the stranger, the naked, the sick, and those in prison. Neither had recognized Christ. Both groups had failed to perceive that the ones in need were Christ. Yet the faithful had provided without even realizing that they were serving Jesus. Certainly, those who had neglected to do good would have helped those in need if they had realized that they would have been serving Christ in that process. They were invisible. Just as we had walked along those streets in Washington, D.C. and not seen those in need, those who were serving or not serving in this parable did not recognize Christ. Are those who are in need invisible to us as well? Do we fail to see Christ's face in those around us? Do we really see Jesus? Is it that we fail to see Jesus around us, or is it that we just fail to see the people who are in need around us? Who is invisible? Who do we fail to see? Many times I've driven to Birmingham, and even when coming back into Pell City and gotten off at the exit ramp here off the interstate, you'll see someone standing there with a sign that says something like, "Please help," or "We'll work for food." And what do we do? What do you do when you see people like that? Many of us will not make eye contact. We will look the other way, because if we look at that person, we are acknowledging them, and in some way we may feel like we need to do something as well. There are many times that other people are invisible to us because we simply don't want to see them. But there are other times that people are invisible to us because we just don't recognize that they do have needs. There are many people who live with us, who may be living next door to us, who may be people who work with us. They may be people whose children go to school with our kids, and they have great needs that are just invisible to us, that we don't recognize that those needs are there, that they are hungry, that they are lonely, that they are in need of clothing, whatever it might be. We just don't see those people. Adam Hamilton tells a story in his book, Why. And in it, he relays an incident that happened to him one night as he was leaving the church. He was tired, he was ready to go home, and he was walking through their campus. And he walked through a part of it where a woman had said to him, "Hello, Pastor Adam." And he had walked on and said, "Oh, hello," and kept walking to his car. But when he got to the parking lot, he heard in his heart the question, "Did you really see her?" And at that prompting, he felt like he needed to go back and speak to the woman, which he did. He went back to where she was, and when he looked at her, he realized that she had been crying and that she really was in need of some help, that she was mourning and grieving the loss of her son and was there at their columbarium where the boy had been buried. And it was then that he realized that he had not really seen her until he took the time to look fully into her eyes. There are many hurting people in this world who often are invisible to us because we are not willing to look into their faces and really see who they are. Christ calls us to see other people and to recognize them as children of God, to recognize Christ in their faces. And once we see those people, we know that we must serve them as well. Jesus reminds us in this scripture that we are called to serve those who are most in need by giving them the things that they need. Whether they're hungry or thirsty or a stranger or sick, Christ calls us to see these people and to serve them as best we can, recognizing that they are also the image of God. John Wesley tells a story. John Wesley is the founder of Methodism, and when he was a college student, he was part of a group of young men that called themselves the Holy Club. And they took this scripture to heart, and they would visit those who were sick, who were in prison. They would, out of their own pocket, help support those who needed financial help. So one day, he tells the story that he was visiting a girl who was poor and who they were helping to pay for her to go to school. And she seemed cold and hungry, and he said to her, "You seem half starved. Have you nothing to cover you but that thin linen gown?" And she said that was all that she had. Wesley put his hand in his pocket, and then he realized that he hardly had any money left because he had just purchased some framed pictures to put on his dorm room. In writing about it later, Wesley said that he heard what he might have heard from God sarcastically saying, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have adorned your walls with the money which might have screened this poor creature from the cold." He felt a weight of guilt for having spent his money on something just to make his room nice when this young woman really could have used a coat. At times, we fail to recognize Christ in the faces of those who are hungry, who are thirsty or imprisoned, who are sick, or who are strangers to us. One of the professors, though, at Duke when I was there, liked to say that we need to imagine that before each person, there is an angel who walks, who says, "Make way for the image of God. Make way for the image of God." For each of us is a treasured person in God's eyes. Each of us is uniquely made in God's image. But sometimes it is hard for us to see the image of God in others. Yet when we look at this passage from Matthew, it is a reminder that we have from Jesus that we need to see the face of Christ in those around us. We need to especially look into the eyes of those who are in need, those who are the least, the last, and the lost, those who are hungry and thirsty, naked, imprisoned, sick, and those who are still strangers to us. When I think about serving those in need, the person who often comes to my mind is Mother Teresa of Calcutta. She was someone who saw people. She could see in them the image of God. And she often wrote about her experiences because she believed that Jesus was telling us to love as I have loved you. And this is what she wrote at one point. "What a trust it is for God to place suffering people in our hands. It is a sacred vocation for us all. Sacred because each of them is a life that God has created in God's own image. Today in this world, God has made us to be His love and compassion, and we become God's love as we pray and as we come to see Christ's face in the lonely eyes of others." Christ calls us to not be so absorbed in our own lives that the focus is only on ourselves and other people become invisible to us. Rather, when we center ourselves in Christ, we begin to see others with new eyes. We begin to see in them Christ. And it is only when our lives are centered in Christ that we can begin to make that eye contact with those whose eyes we have avoided. And we begin not only to see them, but to see them as Christ sees us. Once we see them as Christ, then we need to serve them as Christ. Jesus reminded us in this scripture that we have to serve those who are in need by giving them the things that they need. Whether they're hungry or thirsty or a stranger, we're called to give them those things. And often when we see the needs, we really do want to help. And sometimes, though, we're overwhelmed by that. When we see someone who is without a home, we want to at least give them something to eat. And then we think, well, maybe I can help them find shelter or a job, or then they need a home. And we begin to be overwhelmed by all the things that they need. But if we look clearly at this scripture, what Jesus is asking of us is maybe just a little thing, just to give the person who is thirsty a cup of cold water, to give the person who is hungry a meal, to sit by the bedside of someone who is sick, or just to visit with someone who is in prison. We are called just to meet those needs that we can, that we do have the means to help with. And we do it not because it brings us a good feeling, but because we know in doing it that we are living out Christ's commands, that we are being the heart, the hands, the feet, the body of Christ in this world. When we place ourselves in Christ's care, when we center our lives in Christ, we learn to give over all of who we are to Christ's control. And we find ourselves becoming Christ's heart and hands and feet. And we begin to see those around us through Christ's eyes, and we recognize their needs. It's easy to overlook other people, to begin to avoid that eye contact, to not see the needs, simply because we are not looking. But Jesus invites us to look and then to serve. So might God open all of our eyes that we can see Christ standing right in front of us. When did you see me? Jesus asks us, when did you see me? Will you pray with me? Gracious God, we turn to you knowing that you love us beyond what we can think or imagine. And yet, there are so many times when we fail to recognize that you are here with us. We live in a world where there is so much struggle. There are so many people who do not have enough to eat, for those who do not have any sort of shelter. We pray for those who lack the basic necessities of life. Help us to be those who are willing to share the resources that you have given to us. Help us to be more generous in all the aspects of our lives. Help us not to hoard our resources out of anxiety or ignorance or selfishness. Open our eyes to your presence among us and free us for joyful giving. We pray these things through Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Might you go forth looking for Christ everywhere. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Is right.